You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI show where we look at the version 2 of Form Recognizer. There's some amazing things in there. You're not going to want to miss it. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI show where I am happy to introduce again, Anna Roth is here. How you doing, my friend?
Great. How about you?
Fantastic. For those that don't remember what you do, why don't you remind us?
Yes, I'm a program manager on the cognitive services team, and I work on Form Recognizer and OCR.
Fantastic. So for those that don't know anything about Form Recognizer, why don't you get us up to speed?
Absolutely. So Form Recognizer is a cognitive service, and it's designed to let you extract structured content from forms, so all kinds of forms. So what you get out of Form Recognizer are key value pairs from an image of a form or a PDF. So here, for example, I'd want to extract things like the name, the social security number, the spouse's name, social security number, address, etc. And you can see that I can pull that out as kind of key valued pairs, so I can, you know, put it into a database or some kind of an RPA system or something like that.
So what I've heard RPA, what's an RPA system?
Sure. So RPA stands for robotic process automation. You can think of it as a way to automate sort of common clerical tasks that you might otherwise have to do by hand. So for example, rather than manually doing all the data entry, you know, you could scan a form, do an extraction, and then check back and say, okay, was that extraction correct?
Next question. So again, for those that haven't seen this before, does it pull all, is there like a restriction on the kinds of forms? What kind of key value pairs does it pull out? Just general knowledge here.
Absolutely. So with Form Recognizer, we have some pre-built forms, but also what we call custom forms. And so that's the ability to actually train your own custom model to recognize the content that you care about. And so, you know, in that case, there's all kinds of different forms that, you know, different businesses, different business processes might have. And with Form Recognizer, you kind of train a model to recognize your specific forms and the key value pairs that you want to extract.
So in essence, it's really any form that your business uses, you can totally use this software for.
Exactly. I mean, that's the goal.
So the next question is, so that's a really good introduction to Form Recognizer. The next question is, what's new for those that are already familiar?
Absolutely. So we've had a ton of updates this summer. So first of all, we have V2.0 is now generally available. So it's kind of the first time we've taken Form Recognizer to GA. Two, we have new SDKs. So we've updated the SDKs for .NET, Python, Java, JavaScript. Big enhancements to table extraction, table detection, support for global currencies, support for Azure Gov, as well as enhanced security features like customer managed keys and private endpoints.
And so there's one more thing you were going to tell me about, right?
That's right. Yeah. So we also have the Form Recognizer V2.1 public preview now available, which has a bunch of new features. So the first is language support. We've gone from just supporting English to supporting Dutch, English, French, German, Italian, Portuguese, and Spanish. And then layout, which is the part of Form Recognizer that's more, it's a pre-built model for text and table extraction, will support Chinese.
So these are all cool things. I mean, for those that don't know, they send me something and they're like, we want to talk about this new cool thing. So I knew there was a preview was coming up. So for each of those languages, you mean that it will recognize the key and the value for those languages?
Yeah. So, you know, the first thing when we add new languages, we're really kind of adding new OCR support. And so now you can, you know, train a custom model for any of those languages, and you ought to be able to kind of train to recognize key value pairs across those languages.
Okay. So sorry, I interrupted you, but I love languages. And so this is interesting to me. So tell me about all the other things.
Absolutely. So we support now also checkboxes and like selection marks. So you have like a little checkbox in your form, both in layout and train with labels.
Hold on. So that's even like, so sorry, I keep interrupting because the other question I have, does this work with like actual handwriting as well? Because when I see a checkbox, I literally think of me and my pen just like either putting an X or an actual check mark, and that works.
I'm glad you asked us. No worries about the interruption, because that is a key feature actually of Form Recognizer, is we have a very high quality handwriting OCR model. So we're able to recognize both printed and handwritten text.
and the X or the checkbox or the check mark.
That's right. So if someone's handwritten a little X in the form, that ought to work just as well as if you have like a printed check mark.
Awesome. So that was the last interruption before I do it again. Please go ahead.
For sure. So we added model compose. So that lets you compose multiple different models that you've trained so that you can call them with a single ID. And so kind of what that means is we'll then do a classification step and try and figure out which of your models it is at prediction time. Support for friendly model names, new pre-built model for business cards, new locales for pre-built receipts, and then big quality improvements across the different operations.
Cool. So this is the next time. So model compose is interesting to me because I'm not sure I quite understand. Because you said there's a way to actually train for your own kinds of forms. What does it mean? Like, I guess I'm having a hard understanding. If I have like five different kinds of forms, I have to call each one and I have to know in advance what form it is. Does this make that requirement go away? And if so, how?
So that's exactly what Model Compose is designed to kind of help solve for. So with Form Recognizer, you train a custom model basically kind of for each template or for each layout that you are trying to recognize. And so, you know, let's say you do have kind of five different forms that you want to recognize or five kind of major variants of your form, you know, you would train five different models. But maybe you don't know, you know, because your customers are submitting this via kind of an online process or you have multiple, you know, you might be getting kind of different forms at once. You might not know which are the five forms you've actually received when you have a form you want to predict on. And so what this lets you do is you can kind of compose all five together, send us a form and say, hey, this is a form, please tell me what the content is. And we'll actually do a classification, figure out which of the five forms it is, and then give you the key value pairs for that exact form.
Okay, so if I'm understanding right, you, and I'm not saying this is what you're doing, but basically you have some like logistic regression or something or some other classification algorithm that looks at the form and then tells it which actual model to use. So it's like a machine learning model before it does the machine learning model for form recognition.
Yeah, something like that.
So that sounds awesome. I'd love to see it in action.
Absolutely. So let's take a look. I'm going to kind of show, I think, actually most of the things that are new in the 2.1 preview. So what we're seeing here is our FOTT tool. So this is an open source tool for labeling data, which is usually the first step when people are creating a custom forms model, although it's optional. You know, you can do everything using the APIs if you prefer. But for the demo, it's a little easier to show here. And so I'm trying to train a new custom forms model to recognize this form, which is the IRS form 8821. And so what I'm going to do, I've previously created a couple of tags that I want to recognize, and now I'm going to go and label this form with these tags. So let's take a look.
As you're labeling, because I know this is very compelling television, I have never seen this particular, is this a new, what is this program you're labeling things with? I've never seen it before.
So this is FOTT. It's like an open source tool, a companion kind of sample tool to Form Recognizer, so that you can have like a labeling interface if you need one.
I see. So like this is not, this is something that I can take and put into my own business as part of my online software for, we get a new form, I can mark it up and it goes into the system kind of thing.
Exactly. It's on GitHub. You can reskin it. You know, we've had customers do that where they'll just take it and reskin it or kind of put it into an existing UX experience. Yep. So what I've done kind of while we've been chatting, I've gone through and actually labeled all of these key value pairs. So you saw kind of, I would select one of these and I would say, okay, that's the taxpayer. Selected this text, said that's the appointee. And so I'm kind of giving examples that I'm then going to train on, so that we can kind of have our custom model. So these are the kind of key value pairs that I want to go and extract from this form. And that includes, in this case, the check marks, right? So it says here, you know, this example is unselected, selected, selected, unselected. Now, I went ahead earlier, just because of how compelling this television is, yes, and labeled the rest of these forms. You didn't have to kind of watch me label every single one. So now we have five labeled examples. We're ready to train our model.
So you only need five examples to train the thing, right?
That's exactly right.
Okay. And by the thing, I mean form recognizer. I wasn't trying to,
Five is kind of good to start. You know, you may want to increase depending on the complexity of the form, but with five, you can start training a model. So now I'm going to give this kind of a model-friendly name, so we're just going to call this the AI show, but we'll call it form 8821, so I kind of know what this is.
Okay.
And I'm going to hit train. And so now I'm kind of training a new custom model that is specific to the key value pairs that I just labeled. I get an estimate of the accuracy of my model here. And now let's see model compose in action. So previously, in addition to form 8821, I also went and labeled and trained a different template, our credit card authorization template. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select, you can see here's the model ID that I just trained for form 8821, and here's the credit card authorization. And I'm going to hit compose. And so we'll call this new composed model, we'll call this the AI show model. And so now I'm composing these two together. So I can submit either the credit card authorization form or form 8821, which is a form that actually authorizes viewing tax forms, to one model ID. This AI show model, so you can see that kind of means it's a composed model. And it should be able to extract the content from either form now.
So let me make sure I understood the steps. The first step you did was you trained the form 8821 by labeling five. Well, you labeled one, but labeling five, created the model, called it form 8821 with the new feature with the nice model name instead of the, I think that's a GUID. And the second thing you did is you said, okay, there's another form that we had. Let's just put those together. And then it did its magic. First question, is that right?
That's exactly right.
First question, how many models can be composed together?
So today it's up to 100.
Holy cow, that's pretty cool. The second question is, like, how long does this inference take to run this kind of thing?
Sure, so it's a couple of seconds. You know, maybe on the order of 8 to 10 in most cases. Should we see it in action?
Let's try it.
All right, so first I'm gonna grab one of our form 8821s.
And this is a new form or is it one of the older ones?
So it's a new form.
Okay.
And let's go and click run analysis. And so once again, I'm doing this here in this tool, but I could also have downloaded this Python script so that I could do this programmatically.
Got it.
All right, so we've got our results. Let's take a look here. So we went ahead and extracted the content from this form. So we have our taxpayer here, our appointee, our CAF number, et cetera, and all of these key value pairs that we previously trained have kind of been extracted. I can also download this so we can see the actual kind of JSON that's outputted. So, like Martha Stewart, I actually already did this, so we can kind of see this here. But form recognizer will kind of give you the structured output, so we kind of go and extract our key value pairs.
Can you pause right there? Because I want to make sure people see this, because when I figured this out, because I did something with not the version 2, but the version 1, the bounding box basically tells you exactly where on the file, like where it is, right? The text or the value that it found, right?
That's exactly right.
And then the other question I have, oh, sorry, go ahead.
You're getting the key value pairs, you're getting the location, and we didn't show it earlier, but you're also actually getting the underlying table structure. So there's like a bunch of tables on that form, and that's being extracted for you too.
And then the other question that I had is, when I think of bounding boxes, I'm usually thinking of image files. You were showing PDFs. What other files can people use with this?
So we support PDFs as well as a number of common image formats, JPEGs, PNGs, et cetera.
So basically, if you take a picture of a piece of paper that maps to a form, it will still work.
That's right, yeah.
That's pretty cool. The other question I have is, when you submitted this particular form to that model, was that the composed model that it you submitted it to?
That's right. Actually, I think we can now show, let's grab an example of our other form. Okay. So you can see here we had our 8821. Now I'm actually going to grab and we're going to do an analysis on a different form. So this was our credit card authorization form. So here we have our credit card authorization form. Now I'm going to actually run analysis here. So once again, we're using our AI show model. I'm going to run this analysis. And what I expect now is that the key value pairs that are specific to this form are going to be extracted. And so you can see here, the first thing we get is this doc type. So we've classified, we think that this is the AI show model credit card authorization form as opposed to the 8821, which is correct. And we also get a confidence score here. So we have pretty high confidence. This is not our 8821, which is right because this like isn't the same form. You know, this is our authorization form. And now you can see all of these key value pairs have been extracted that are specific to this form here.
Including the signature, which is what goes back to actual handwriting.
That's right, yeah.
That's really cool. I mean, is it so people can download all of this stuff and try it out? Where can people go to find out more, get the source code for this stuff?
That's a great question. So we have a bunch of resources available online. So you can go to this page to get kind of top level information about Form Recognizer. We have our documentation page, which includes links to the open source tool I showed earlier, as well as kind of quick starts, SDKs, et cetera. Some documentation on our OCR/read API, which is if you just want to kind of extract text, as well as, you know, contact us either through Azure support or, you know, via this email address.
That is fantastic. Well, this has been amazing. Thank you so much for spending some time with us. And it's always a pleasure to have you on. And again, thank you for watching and learning all about Form Recognizer V2 and 2.1 preview with something called Model Compose, which seems pretty awesome. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Take care.
Thanks so much. Bye-bye.